All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in and welcome back to our channel. Today, you guys, we're going to be using a little steel 170 chainsaw. We're working on our trails going up and down our road here because trees are starting to grow into them. We thought, you know what, let's try out the little Milwaukee.
And our fruit.
Yeah, and our fruit trees, our little hacksaw. We've been using this on our fruit tree and just been loving it. I mean, it's so light and portable. And this would be a great thing to pack around on your ATV when you're out cruising around on the trails. And you can see, look how quick it cuts these limbs. And this is something that I'll be able to let my son use while I'm running my chainsaw. And that way we're working together. Michael feels like he's accomplishing something. And it's good to be out here with your son working together. So Michael.
Hold up here.
Yep, hold it tight. And the reason why we're trimming these trees off also, you guys, oh, and leaving the little stumps out, is you want these to kind of rot out and fall off, and the tree will actually form a natural scab over that. And as the tree grows, you won't even notice that. Sometimes you can cut them off level, and the scabs still seal up, but they tend to get like a bug or a parasite inside. So just leave that's a little bit long, just a little bit less than a quarter of an inch of a stump. And that way that tree will rot out and seal and protect your tree so you don't damage your fir tree as it's growing. So, all right, Michael, you continue doing that and I'll work over on my own.
And mine, and me.
Yep.
Cut that. Okay. I cut this. Tip about these trees, you guys, if you look at, I'll show you, you limit these trees, you know, fir trees need to have limbs. If you go too aggressive up on a tree, especially when they're young, you'll actually kill them. So that's why we're only going up, you know, 4.5, maybe 5 feet tops, depending on how big your tree is. If you don't want to take off too many limbs, it'll kill your tree. So the reason why that's not working?
Good job, babe. I made a quick dash to the barn to get some ear protection for running those chainsaws. We forgot to bring them up with us, so here I am making a quick dash back. Now I'm going to run back and hand it over to Handsome. I will show you on the way back all the progress we've made on our trails so far on cutting down these limbs. So I will show you some work we've done over here on the side of our hay field. About 10 years old. Anyway, we're increasing the space and the light between them. We'll be bunching up limbs and burning them too as well to make it cleaner. Show you more of the trail up the hill there. So occasionally our trails need a little maintenance as well as our timber trees. We have replanted. They're all about getting close to 10 years old, getting real bushy, growing into the path. This is something that Ben has been working on while I homeschool Michael, or sometimes a family effort on other days. So I'll show you what we've done so far.
All right, so here we are with the Milwaukee. Let's see if it'll cut through an alder. It's probably an inch and a half or 2 inches through. Go for it, bud. You push it down?
Yep.
Go. I would think it would have cut faster. Okay, ready, left. All right, so that's a great review. So I would say that these limbs here are too big for the Milwaukee. You know, of course, we're not really supposed to be using this for this, but it works awesome for little limbs, probably an inch or less. It seems to get bound up when you're cutting through. So anyways, that was a good test. All right, bud, let's go chop that tree.
What you doing there, Stead?
I'm sleepy.
You're sleepy? Are you ready for a hot dog barbecue soon? Are you ready for a hot dog barbecue soon? Are you ready for a hot dog barbecue soon? Good.
Okay, you guys, here's another quick fire starter. So this is a little piece of cardboard. I got cardboard boxes stashed under all my limbs. Take a little piece of cardboard, put it inside your chainsaw gas. You don't need much, just a little bit. Set that right in there. And the cardboard will actually soak up the gas so you don't get that poof. See? Now we have our fire started. Next. Good job. Okay, get ready. Okay, next. Okay, one more. Go. Wow, good job. Punch it. Boy, you guys, I think this thing would actually work. Absolutely amazing. Hold on. Absolutely amazing if you're just doing a couple, few fruit trees. Doing a few little limbs. This thing is actually really sharp. I really like it. And Michael loves it. And of course, you know, get the little ones out, get them experiencing things. This is when they learn the most. Okay, go. Good job. Let's get this little whisker. Okay, go. Okay, perfect. Ah, it just cuts right through those. That's really cool. This one? Okay, go. Seems like when you hit. Quick, get out of the smoke, run! Here, this is great. So I actually limbed this here 2 years ago. You can see how it's starting to create a scab and scab over everything. And then here's a fresh cut that I just made because the tree's getting bigger. So yeah, those things will scab over you guys, rot off, fall off, and you will have something that looks like that, just a scab over. And when we're out here in our actual timber trees, limbing this little bit of bottoms off, I leave the limbs because you want it to rot back and just give it back to the soil. And when we're out here on our main road, and we're trying to make it wide enough so we can get a tractor down it, and of course we burn the limbs to clean it up, make it look like a park. All right, so, we just got done doing a bunch of clearing, and now we're gonna have a little hot dog barbecue for everybody. So I'm gonna make a hot dog stick, like a little two-prong hot dog stick, so I can cook two at a time. Just kind of sharpen up the ends so it slides on your hot dog okay. Okay, so you guys, so if you check out one of our previous videos, these are our homemade sausage bratwurst that we made. And this is either deer, elk meat, or even you just buy beef at Costco and pork and mix it in. And it's definitely interesting to try. It's a lot harder than I thought it would be, but man, it's a flavor good. As cool that you're eating your own meat, you know exactly what's in your bratwurst. You see how yummy it is.
Show me what we got, Wyatt.
Got these.
Ooh.
Yeah, a ketchup.
Oh, yeah.
And these.
Pickles.
Oh, that's got fun.
All right.
And fish some crackles. And fish crackles.
All right. Hot dogs are almost done cooking.
Bananas.
Woohoo.
That's cute.
Here comes Daddy.
All right.
Milk.
Here's our homemade bratwurst.
All right.
Let's eat. Who's hungry?
Me.
Me.
Oh.
That one might be
mine.
No,
it's
I yours. Said.
How's your pear, bud?
Mm-mm.
Got mama in there?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.